As the Christmas baking and candy making continues, I have so many great recipes I want to share with you. This one is quite an old recipe, and a lot of you may not know what it is, but it really is one of my favorites. My grandma introduced me to it, and it's called sponge candy. It gets its name from, of course, the texture of the final product that really looks airy and almost sponge-like. It is quite different and the ingredients sound odd, but hang on and just try it because I think once you do, you're going to be as hooked as I am on this old-time confection. To start, in a heavy bottom saucepan, just place your dark karo syrup, a little bit of dark molasses, a little bit of vinegar, and just a little sugar. Put that on the stove over medium to medium high heat, and this is where it takes a little bit of time, and like so many candies, you have to be extremely careful. You want to bring it up to hard crack stage. That's 300 degrees. It takes quite a while, but be patient and just make sure to keep testing with your thermometer. If you don't have a good instant read thermometer, use a candy thermometer that just fits right onto your saucepan. Slowly stir it and watch it carefully as it's coming up to the temperature. While it's warming up, make sure to have ready a large pan that you're going to pour this into. You can either use a 9x13 or a larger 10x15 pan like I'm using. Just make sure to butter and grease the sides and bottom of the pan really well so it comes out easily when you want to crack it up. Also have ready a little bit of baking soda. This you're going to need to throw in at the very end when it reaches the temperature and then pour it right into the pan. So it's best to have it ready to go so you don't need to run around when it's so hot. Keep stirring it on the stove as it comes up to temperature, and once it reaches that hard crack stage, pull it off the heat immediately and add in your baking soda. Stir until it is completely in there, and as you can see, it changes consistency and kind of gets foamy, and then pour it directly into your prepared pan. Put it in a cool place and let it cool completely before you try to do anything with it. But once it is cooled, you can just kind of start breaking it up with your hand into whatever size pieces you want. I kind of love the odd shapes it produces, and so I don't try to make them perfect. Just have odd shapes, big and small. That way anyone can choose what they want. To finish this off, sometimes I dip it in chocolate, but this year I'm just drizzling the top with a good bittersweet chocolate. This just adds a hint of sweetness and a unique flavor and really finishes it off with a perfect look. I hope you try this coming season because it is such a fun candy to make. And I think everyone who tries it is gonna love the recipe. Enjoy. Thanks for watching this video. To watch more Christmas videos, click over here and click below to subscribe. Please leave comments and questions below on all the videos, as I love reading how you guys use my recipes and ideas for inspiration around your own home.